don't have the problem, we don't want to take any chances in this case. You need to know your capabilities. Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Let's get started. Today, we are going to discuss this case, when we used all the implants for temporary restoration and made the restoration something like Maryland. It's something that is not widely used, but it's a great solution. When you have already had the implants, you extract the tooth and then you need to replace the tooth somehow. In this case, we want to extract tooth number 21. Of course, it's an aesthetic problem when you extract this frontal tooth and you need to have an immediate solution for some temporary restoration. In many cases, you take impressions before the extraction. You make a Maryland bridge and you cement the Maryland bridge so it would replace that tooth. So in this case, what we did, we took an impression on those implants and we made a Maryland bridge to restore tooth 21. The old bridge was based on multi-units, and we took impressions on those multi-units, made a screw-retained Maryland bridge, and then later on, the screw-retained Maryland bridge was screwed to those two multi-units, and it had a short span of three teeth and the crown that we wanted to restore. So in this case, what we'll get is the same as the Maryland bridge, but you don't have the problem of detrimentation. You won't have that problem that the patient come back to your clinic. Now, after the extraction, we added another implant. What we want to show is the temporary restoration and not the end result. Of course, you can have an immediate implantation and you can even have immediate loading, but if you have immediate loading on the frontal tooth, you'll have pressure on this tooth. An immediate implantation with immediate restoration is a problem in frontal teeth because they have a lot of vertical forces and it can interfere with the osseointegration. And then we can't be sure that the end result will be fine. We can't be sure that we'll get an osseointegration. We don't want to take any chances in this case. So in many cases, we try to avoid immediate loading. About the immediate implantation or not, it's probably what the doctor prefers, whether you have inflammation or you have enough bone. You have a lot of questions, but this is not the case. It doesn't really matter what you want to do with the implant. You can wait 3 or 4 months. Even if you make the implant right away, or even if you choose to make the implant afterwards, you have the temporary restoration. If it's screw-retained restoration, you can just screw it away. You just put the implant and you screw back in the temporary restoration. You just need the restoration to not interfere with the gingiva. So here you can see the space we took off the bridge, and here he is missing one tooth. Now, let's look at how the screw-retained Maryland bridge looks like. You can see you have two abutments and two sleeves for those two crowns with multi-units. You have this span that we added a little bit of composite to fit exactly with the contour of the teeth, and we have this tooth. This is the missing tooth we want to restore temporarily. Later on, when we'll take it out and give you the Maryland bridge, you need to cement it back because in this case, if it falls out, it came from the same day. It can't even go one day without this tooth. Composite will stick to the temporary bridge. We'll just take it out as one piece. And if we want to return it back, we can always return it by just returning it with the screws. It would hold pressure, but it's made from PMMA. You need to know your capabilities. If you think that it wouldn't hold, you can make it from a different material. You can maybe choose a PEEK or some fiberglass reinforcement. And then the buckle parts, you can add composite for the aesthetic, but from our experience with PMMA, for shorter periods of time, it's good enough and it will hold. It's simpler than a Maryland bridge because a Maryland you can't make from PMMA. The wings won't hold. You need to make it from a metal or a tougher material. In this case, you can have a simpler restoration. It's a restoration that probably won't break and you know it will hold for enough time as a temporary restoration. Because you already have those implants in there close to the teeth you want to restore, you can use it as a temporary restoration. So in here, we're sure it will hold. And when we're taking it off these crowns, when we restore the missing tooth, we just return to the old crowns back. Here you can see it as a temporary restoration. We have those two crowns that we restored upon, and we closed the whole different PMMA, no problem at all. Here we made an exact copy of tooth 11. We took a little bit of the occlusion so it wouldn't interfere in its movement because you don't want it to move or break. So the tooth is a little bit shorter. With a Maryland bridge, you'll have the same. You have the same shorter tooth, you have the same results, but in here, you know that you won't have this cementation. It will hold on these two implants, and this is a temporary restoration, a great restoration for short periods of time. So the next step is just permanent restoration. The next step is taking it off, taking impressions, probably returning it because you don't want to send the patient home without a tooth. And when you have the permanent tooth, you just replace this bridge with the original bridge he had. And in this tooth, you just place the permanent tooth. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. See you next time.